at it again with another video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed my last video, which is my PC build. Had lots of fun building that thing. Hopefully if you guys did watch it, you guys enjoyed it, you guys laughed, you guys cried. It was a fun time. Lots of fails, lots of little quirky things that I did and didn't do. Trust me, my friends got on me for that. But I will be leaving a link down in the description below for you guys to go check it out if you guys didn't get a chance to watch it. Today we're going to be reviewing and looking at the Razer Black Widow X Chroma keyboard. Very excited. I got that here recently as a gift for my girlfriend, so thank you to her. Very nice, very tacked out, very clicky keyboard, and I'm very excited to kind of go more in depth and to actually give you guys more of a, you know, in-depth review on this keyboard, because in my opinion, I think it's a pretty good keyboard. And I think if you are a gamer and you are kind of, you want to get more into the gamer scene with the RGB lights and everything, I think the Razer Black Widow X Chroma keyboard would be a cool thing to have, you know, for your little setup. So let's stop talking and let's review this thing. So the keyboard has two plastic feet and four rubber corners, so that when you are typing on it, when you're playing your games, it does not slide around or scratch the table underneath you, whether it is a glass table or maybe even a nicer, you know, faux wood table. It'll prevent it from scratching, which is really nice. Of course, it's standard, you know, with all keyboards to have those rubber feet, but you know, it's nice that it has it anyway. When you use the two plastic feet on the bottom of the keyboard, it does give you a really nice incline, which is really nice in my opinion. I've used a few other keyboards, you know, whether it's Corsair or other Razer keyboards, and I really feel like those keyboards don't give you enough incline when you pop up those two little plastic feet in the back. And so it helps a lot, you know, when you're playing games, when you're just, you know, regularly typing. So that way you're not really straining your wrist too much, and when you're, you know, doing work, when you're like using your computer for long periods of time. Because I know sometimes, you know, you can just set a computer for an hour, maybe even 4, 6, or 7 if you're gaming. It just kind of depends, you know. And so having that nice incline on the keyboard really gives you that extra ergonomicness, if you want to say. So that way you're not really straining yourself too much. So aside from the plastic feet and rubber guards underneath the keyboard, each keycap is illuminated by individual LED nodes. This is kind of important just because some, depending on what style keyboard you're getting, the LED nodes might be underneath like a plastic fitting inside the keyboard, which doesn't really give you that vibrant look. Yes, they might be colorful. Yes, they might look cool, but you're not really getting that color to shine through as I believe you should. By information given by Razer, you do have a choice between 16.8 million color options, which, you know, through the Synapse program that Razer does have available to, you know, everyone, whoever gets the keyboard, you can choose between all those different colors and kind of different color combinations, which is pretty awesome. And especially, you know, with the metallic finish on the actual keyboard, you see the, you know, lights shine even brighter than before, which is pretty awesome. Now the keys in the keyboard are known as Razer's very own green switches. They're supposed to be the more, you know, tactile and clicky switches that you can get out. And to make it a little more comparable to you guys, if you guys aren't familiar with Razer switches, they're most comparable to the Cherry MX Blues in terms of sound and feel. And to get a bit more in depth very quickly, the Razer switches go by three different colors. They go by orange, yellow, and green. Yellow being the quietest, orange being right in the middle, and green being the most clickiest and tactile. Now, with the Black Widow having the green switches, it does need to travel approximately 1.9 millimeters for it to actuate or for it to register as a keystroke before bottoming out at the 4 millimeter mark. Now, I know what you might be thinking, you know, 50 grams, that sounds like a lot, but for a true mechanical keyboard, it's not too bad at all. It really, you know, when you're pushing on the keys, it almost makes you fight back a little bit. When you're pushing down, it pushes back up against your finger, which is pretty nice. So that way, you know that the keyboard is responding to your keystrokes, which in my opinion is very effective. You know, when you're playing your games, you know what you're doing, you know what you're pressing, you know where you're going, pretty much. And it really is very vital to the mechanical keyboard, you know, feel when you're, you know, wanting to buy one or get a mechanical keyboard. Now I know you may be wondering, how loud are they? How loud do they actually get? Well, hopefully with this audio sample, you'll be able to hear what they sound like. But granted, you know, this is on the camera, so you're not gonna get the true feeling unless you actually go test them out at like your local Best Buy or your local, you know, tech store, where they might have, you know, sample, like a little sample switch, group of switches that you can test out through Razer. So let's see what it sounds like. Now, one thing that like a lot of people leave out would be the Synapse program that Razer has for the keyboards and mice. It really is very functional. It's easy to get around. There is a bit of a learning curve in terms of like how it looks and the layout. But once you get used to, you know, going through the functions, you know, going through how to set up your keys, what effects you want in terms of like lighting and how it looks, whether it's waves, static, ripple effect. It's very easy to go through. It's very easy to assign keys, and the more they roll out, you know, more updates for their Synapse program, I can guarantee you it's going to get even better than what it is right now. It's just one of the few things that a lot of people kind of leave out in these videos is the programs that go with the keyboards or the mice, which I think is very important. So through the Synapse program that Razer does have for their gaming keyboards and mice, you can see some quick effects that they have. That includes breathing, fire, reactive, ripple, spectrum cycling, starlight, static, and wave. And I will be, you know, doing short clips to kind of show you what it looks like, which I will be starting right now. Those you can change the brightness, you can change, you know, you can go to the advanced effects and go into the Chroma Studio. You can switch on and off the lighting, you know, when turn off when your display is turned off. Small things that really make a big difference, you know, either when you're gaming or when you're done gaming, which is pretty nice to include, you know, with all their different technologies that they do have. All right, guys, so to end this video, this keyboard wins in my books. When it comes to the quality of the build, the lights and the programs, it's just perfect. Especially if you're in the market for a gaming keyboard, this should totally be on top of your list. As you know, especially for my, you know, few weeks of owning this keyboard, I can say that I love it. I mean, other than, you know, it being a tad bit too loud, it's worth, in my opinion, you know, to get that, you know, that responsiveness that anyone would want from the keyboard. So hopefully this video was helpful for you guys, especially if you guys, you know, are making a decision on a certain keyboard that you guys were looking for. Hopefully my video was full of informational things that helped you, you know, make a decision. I want to tell you guys how thankful I am for you guys clicking on my videos. And if you guys like this stuff, if you guys like my content, leave a like, you know, drop a comment, and subscribe if you guys want more weekly content. See you guys.
Computer right now.
No, wait, put your head back. Wait, I can focus in on your head. Do it again. Hold still. That's actually...